Hello there, everyone! Your robotic overlord, I am Mach 3, welcomes you back to Codex of Victory! Where, in my infinite wisdom, I have done as I suggested at the end of the previous video, and prepared my forces. You will note my resources at the top of the screen are very, very low, but the base has expanded, and I have 80 in my hangar bay. I have a robotic army fit for a robotic overlord, such as myself. And that's enough of that flipping accent. Okay. Sorry, when I do that, it just makes me smile a little inside. Anyway, yes. I said in the previous episode that I would take a little bit of time to gather resources and rebuild my forces before commencing recording this one. And I have done. If you notice the spy stat attack timer down here, it has ticked forward just over 5 days. So that's nearly a third of my allotted time before the spy stat attack gone. In return, I have barely any resources right now, but I have 80 in my vehicle pop, and that's because I've upgraded all three of my hangars to level 2, which is as far as I can push it, and I've been doing a bunch of research. So my forces are in the best shape they have ever been in. So yes, right now I am researching level 3 on the attack vehicles, so they've got an extra hit point. And I think that my mission will start before I actually research level 3 and get them a critical hit chance bonus. But I have been a bit more active than that. This is not all the upgrading I've done. My artilleries are now level 4, which is, as it turns out, as high as the level 1 research center can take things. So it's got better critical hits, it's got more hit points, and it's got an extra module slot in them. I've also ramped up the tanks. Extra hit points, extra range, and an extra 2 points of regeneration. So, these things are actually kind of nuts right now. They are very powerful. Let's go to the module bay and show you what I've done to the things. Now then, I've left the upgrades around where they were, pretty much, so, you know, nothing there. The only difference is I've added regeneration to the gun turret because, you know, it's stationary, I can't move it into a base to repair itself, so it needs some kind of passive regeneration effect on it. But my two key units, which I have the most of, except for the jeeps, are the tanks and artillery. The tanks, well, they've now got a range of 2. They still don't do 3 damage, but they've got 10 hit points, and they recover 4 hit points every turn, so that's nearly half of their hit points coming back after every single turn. It's kind of nuts. These things are definitely going to be the meat shields of my group, and I've got 7 of the things. Then over here, I've got 5 artillery pieces. Yes, they cost 6 AP to deploy, the tanks cost 5, so that's a slight drawback, but they have attack of 4, a range of 5, and a 10% critical chance. And that's because they've got the range boost and the spare module slots. I put back the custom weapon, so that's 1 hit point traded for 1 extra damage. But range of 5. These things are kind of ludicrous and specialised to hide long, long distances behind my front lines and just start shelling everything at random. So that's the general idea there. And just a second, I've dropped my microphone clip. There we go. Okay. Right. So that's that. That's all the prep work I've done. And I've built up spare stocks of most of my vehicle types. So this next mission, it has said, is... Yeah, here we go. I ran through this last time, I think. Wait, did I? I don't know. Okay, voice mode, here we go. My forces go to the Heinlein Crater for a mission called the Uranium Wall. I do not know who names these missions, but their imagination leaves something to be desired. We need to produce uranium to build more powerful units. The Baron protects his uranium mine with lots of heavy weapons, but because of volcanic activity in the area, he will have no reinforcements. Unfortunately, this also means we can only deploy a limited number of units. Yeah, I don't think I did that last time. I'd have remembered if I did, I think. Maybe. Anyway, I have a good pick of units, so I can pick and choose what units I want to put in, I think. But I don't know how limited this is going to be, so here we go. Oh, jeez. Okay. We've got bombs, we've got turrets, we've got artillery, tanks, spider tanks. So, he can't deploy anything else, but he's got a huge range of units, so... I think I'm going to have to rely on the tanks and artillery for this. That's why I focused my research so much on those two units and maxed them out as far as my current tech resources go. Plus, in case you didn't notice, I've actually got 5 artillery pieces and 7 tanks, so... I've got plenty of Oh. Right, it seems I need to deploy everything in one go. And then just murder it all. Okay. I've got 35 points to spend. So that's what it meant by limited units. It's not limited to a number of units. I didn't think it would be, but it's limited to I have this much AP to spend and then I can't bring in anything else. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my artillery can hit that guy from over here, roughly. So... Okay, let's start bringing in artillery. They can't get close enough, so... Actually, that guy might be able to get close enough. That scorpion. I need some tanks on the flank. Some tanks at front. He's got plenty of artillery, but my artillery has better range than his artillery. That attack chopper, though, is a slight concern. Also, his tank... same stats as mine. Except that mine... Well, I don't think he has the same regeneration effects as mine. But anyway, I need spare artillery. I need some jeeps in here. I'm really feeling the high cost. I don't need my turrets at all. Should I bring in the attack chopper for fast airborne combat? Yeah, let's do that. I've got 2 points left. That means I can't bring in the marker drone. I can deploy one last jeep and that's it. So I think that's all I can do. Okay, ready. Your Lordship, there'll be no reinforcements. Be careful with what we have. Yeah, that's why I was suddenly being so careful. Right. Yep, I can hit that from here. Okay. That poor, poor tank. Can I hit it from here? Oh, not quite. Okay, right. Dacker. I'm worried about that tank, that spider's movement. That's why I'm a bit careful. But I can move this attack chopper in and do most of the job. Then I'm going to use the jeep just to capture. So, yeah. Actually, either way, I'm going to need this tank to deal some damage. It's either that or move the artillery piece. So let's get the attack chopper in to finish the job. Then the jeep can do the capture. And I've now got that base to act as a supply point. That's good. If I was to advance this thing to here, I could actually hit pretty damn far, actually. This is good, because I can see where I want. So if I move this thing over here, then I can start hitting things. Of course, I've got to keep it safe. So, how far can those things move? They can move 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So they can hit anything there. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4. They can hit anything there. In these 3 squares. So I can move that there. And that one can move there. Okay, so I'm safe from that drone for the moment, and I can use my attacks to do something else. However, that thing there might be a problem. Let's move my other artillery piece up to position here, get the jeep around there, and then what's your range on those things? 3 attacks, so they can hit anything there, so move that there, form a slight blockade. I might lose an artillery this turn, though. That's the thing. Because that tank could probably move into position and then swat it. That's one risk, but that's... I'm going to have to try it. The artillery's moving back. They're collecting points. Here it comes. Yep, there we go. I was afraid of that. Nope, sorry, my little mini tanks are too tough. Oh, hang on. I thought that was out of range. Eh, whatever. Okay, right. I sacrificed an artillery piece. But that's all okay. Because what I want to do is... Actually, that tank can't get anywhere to be useful, so... I need to... Yeah, that artillery... The only thing that artillery can knock out is my artillery. So I really need to knock out that artillery piece. Yep, you're dead. Haha! Take that. Then this one needs to back the hell out because it's almost dead. But the only safe place to really send it is to here. It's just got to get clear, basically. So back that the hell out. That tank can't get quite in range. So I'm going to lose this artillery next turn as well, it seems. Bugger. Unless... No, that is out of range for that as well. But, bugger. Oh well. Luckily it's got a little bit of attack range, so I can knock out that flyer. But there's nothing I can really do to stop that my other artillery getting knocked out. I should have deployed more artillery and been more careful with them. I think that's the lesson of the day, isn't it? Yeah, I'm definitely going to lose that. That sucks. Actually, I should have moved that jeep there anyway. Look at me, I'm messing up already. What happened to my supreme confidence, eh? I'm losing both my artillery pieces, but my tanks are tough enough to carry most of this, so that should be okay. At least that jeep's surviving for now. Yep, there goes the artillery. It's using advanced units. Be careful of their artillery, which tracks your shells to return fire. What? I don't really get what you mean by that. Is that what support means? I don't know. Anyway, long story short, I lost all my artillery in the opening couple of turns. Sorry. There's nothing I can do about that. But that's okay. I don't really mind that much. Now, if I move that... there... That had a ward? So that's what that ward upgrade does. Okay. Good to know, though it slightly sucks to find that out. But that's okay, I've got enough power here to deal with it. There we go. And... 1, 2, 3, 4. There. So, move that jeep there. Okay. And they didn't do anything. And that jeep is not repairing. So that base can't fix things. That sucks. There's not much I can do about it, though. And that wall prevents me from firing past that, so... I see. And I need to knock down that gate as well. What's the range on that thing? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, so... I'm going to take a couple of knocks here. But there's only one artillery piece there. So, move my tank up to there. Oh, counter-attack. Forgot about that. But the second one knocked it straight out. Then my jeep can go over there and dangle itself as a piece of bait. That's good. And this chopper... The problem is I need to move onto the mountain to actually get into range, so just move that there. Alright, I'm probably going to take an artillery hit here. Yep. Breathe of that, and that artillery is same tank, right? Oop, and yeah, okay, they're going to knock out one of my tanks. Yeah. That cost them a fair bit though to do that. Darn it. I lost one of the heavy units, but that tank recovered a good bit. Okay, now then. Let's see here. I want to... I've got to knock out some of their artillery pieces, because the artillery is going to cost me if I let it just keep doing that. But they've got that heavy gunship running around, which can easily polish off my jeeps now. So I've got to choose what to take down. Okay, let's shoot that thing down immediately. Oh! Support! I see, so that's what support does. If you attack something... Was that in range? 1, 2, 3, 4... Yeah, okay, right. If you attack and your unit's in range of an artillery piece with support, the support unit will fire at you. So that's what it means. Okay. The more you know. I get the feeling I'm not going to win this one. Just a thought. Let's see. My tank can survive a couple of knocks, but he's got to move very carefully. It'd be best if I can knock out one of the artillery pieces immediately. But it's actually better if I can knock that out. I've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 12. I can't kill that in this turn. I'm going to have to take a knock. Nothing to be done about it, but I've got to knock out the artillery. Okay, that's that down. The turrets can't indirect fire, so 3, 6... That's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. They could kill my tank in this turn if I stay within range of that turret. But 5, 6, 7, 8... They can't kill it, though, if it's just those two units doing it. How dare they make this complicated? 1, 2, 3. Right. I need to move to where the jeep is to actually get out of reach. That means I need to move the jeep up. Hit. Move that tank over there. Fire. Do some damage. That can't move. That's all my moves. Okay. What am I going to lose? 8. Oh dear. Nope, they can't quite kill that. Ha ha! Not enough. Look at all those refineries. We'll be able to start producing uranium just as soon as we get rid of the enemy units. Yeah, I'm looking at all the enemy units, thank you. My attack chopper's about to bite the dust, but I need to knock out that artillery piece before I can push forward. That artillery piece is what's clinching the battle right now, so I've got to kill it. However, that means I'm about to lose my chopper, and there's nothing to be done about that. Yeah, can't do a thing about it. 5, 6, 7, 8. These two can dish out 8 per turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. So they can hit anything in that row, so I've got to get my jeeps back to this row. Yeah, they should be safe from the chopper for this turn. But I don't have any support units or healing units. I'm about to lose my chopper. That leaves me with 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 firepower total. I think I'm going to lose this one. And it's because of that blooming attack chopper over there. 2, 3. The tank parking in this row here will be vulnerable to getting hit by that, though. So, move the tank over here and then I can hit the gate, at least. I should have brought more tanks, to be quite honest. Yep, goodbye chopper. You did okay, but... Yep. Oh, that's in range? Bugger. Well, it can recover from that much at least. I need to do something about that. If I can knock out that chopper, I'll be fine. Yeah, you're fine. I'm keeping my jeeps back here for now, though. 5, 6, 7, 8. No. I think I'm about to lose my tank. I'm about to lose my tank. Definitely about to lose my tank. Because that turret's going to finish it. Yep. Oh. There we go. There it is. Yep. Only two jeeps remaining. That's not enough. Now, where's the restart button? Oh, that's a retreat button. No, don't want to retreat. Since it will let me restart if I lose everything, I think. That's preferable, because I'll have all my forces back again. I can't kill anything with two jeeps. Not at all. Didn't even kill the turret. Oh well. And boom. Yeah, restart that, thank you. Anyway, right. That's my main problem, really, because I've got more powerful units, but my units are more costly as a result of all the modifications. So, that is a definite issue. Let's install my two artillery pieces over here, and a pair of jeeps in the front. Yep. Then get some tanks in here, so that's two tanks, two jeeps, two artillery pieces. I need to take better care of those flipping artillery pieces because they are very important. What else can I bring in? I brought in the chopper last time, that was great. But I've got... let's bring in a third artillery and a target marker to more easily deal with heavier units. So, that's a slightly different composition. I've sacrificed my air support for more range. And I think that'll do it. Right. Round two. Have at you, you scum. You scum. Artillery fire. Knock out the tank. Yep. Yep. And now I know I get plenty of action points to use during my turns. So, jeep can finish that tank off. And use that as my supply point. It won't fix anything though, so, you know. Kind of sucks that way, but eh. Can't have everything, can you? Now then, this thing can move pretty well, but I don't want to let it past me. So I'm going to give it a inviting target in the form of these tanks here. Sitting just outside range of those, but I'm going to leave my artillery pieces way behind. I'm also going to move my target marker drone too, so yeah. Okay, those tanks are the base. They're tough, they can take a few hits. But their counter-artillery is kind of nasty. And they almost knocked out one of my tanks already. Cheeky little sods. Okay, right. Let's see. Can't quite move, so I'm going to have to artillery that. I need to... Actually, I don't care about that artillery. I can leave that alive. What I need to do is target mark that. Do I have the range? Yes, I do. I have a range of two, so actually, if I park that there... 1, 2, 3, 4. That could kill their drone if I park it there. So I need to get tricky with my tank movements. I need to move that tank over there. Actually, what am I doing? That artillery will knock out my targeting drone straight away anyway, so... I'm going to lose this targeting drone no matter what. And I'm going to need it. Okay, right. My artillery can hit that tank from here. 4, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to get counter-batteried on this tank by that artillery. So that's going to be good, actually. No, wait, hang on. Duh, wards. That thing has wards on it. It's going to take an extra hit. Let's use the counter-battery on this tank, which has more health, so it can afford it. Yeah, I thought so. Artillery support does the artillery's attack damage. So, okay, that's that. Though that has been damaged, so counter battery fire for me. Yep. And then if I move this one to here, I should be able to knock that straight out. Stacker. That's fine. Just fire on that, I'll get aircraft. That's dead. Then finishing blow for that tank there. Revenge is sweet. Goodbye, robot scorpion. I almost called it a Robion Scorpot, and I don't know why. But, yeah, that's a much better opening. And I'm going to get the jeep over into range as well. So I can use that if I need it. Yeah, okay. That's fine. Okay. Most of their initial wave is exhausted, and I'm still okay. Oh, I'm going to lose an artillery piece. Yeah, there we go. They ran their artillery forward, but that artillery is now very, very doomed. There's nothing that artillery can do to survive. So, I want to knock it out with my jeeps, actually, if I can. But I can't move it. I'll have to use an artillery fire to knock it out. So, yep, artillery here. Point blank, but that took care of it. Okay. Alright. They have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They. 1, 2, 3. So, here, that could fire at that turret. But I want to start getting my artillery up to into range to counter battery theirs. So it needs to be about here, which is going to be in range of that turret. So I need to knock out the turrets. That's okay, I've got plenty of artillery right now, so. Yeah, that should be okay. Right to there. Heavy hits, that'll bring. They'll fix that next turn, because I can't. I'm not going to finish it off this turn, but that's fine. I need to keep my forces back. And they didn't bother. That's fine. Okay. If you guys don't want to send your forces forward, that's fine by me. Move that jeep over there. Move that drone forward. End. Right. Oh, they're going to bother to fix that one. Fair enough. Actually, can I be cheeky and just... I need to move this jeep there to do that, but I want to... Oh, actually, if I move this jeep for... Yeah. I'm going to artillery their aircraft before they get a chance to move it in and attack me with it. So, there we go. Goodbye to that. And then... I might as well knock out their artillery piece over there. So, if I move to there... It should be able to do something. So, yeah. Bang! There goes their second artillery piece. Yes. Relying on my superior artillery range is definitely a good thing. The damage is not really helping so much right now, but that's okay. Actually, I can just rush in and kill that turret now. Except for the fact it counter-attacks. They can't stop me right now. Yep, counter-attack. Fires back. But it's dead. So that's all okay. Forward! Into the breach! Oh, incoming artillery. Hits the tank. Idiot. And their choppers wandered out as well. Oh no, there goes my drone. Quick. Nope, sorry. Not quite enough. My tank's still alive. Ha ha, sucks to be you. Right. What they have just done is very silly, because I still have two artillery pieces on the field. I can knock them straight out. First, let's deal with that annoying thing. Bang, you're dead. Then focus fire straight onto the chopper, because that's the big threat now. Move my tanks and things. That tank's still okay. That jeep's pretty beat up, so I'll move that forward there and just go DACA. DACA. And, yep. DACA. And this jeep will deliver the finishing blow. That chopper which killed me last time is now dead. Haha. Okay. Revenge is satisfied. Next. Alright. I'm going to finish this. This game is working out roughly at one match per video, isn't it? Okay, the last actual dangerous thing is the turret, so... Well, not anymore, apparently. I got a critical hit on it. Right. Let's just knock out their repair unit over here and do that. Just start forcing the gates down to get at their last unit. So yeah, that's that, that's that, that's that. And they have nothing left, basically. All they've got is that last healing aircraft. So that's fine. Actually, I can finish this right now. Unless the gate counts. Was that it? Yep, that was it. Hooray, victory! Uranium factory thingy is my... Ooh. I can build scorpion tanks. Ha-ha! Excellent. I've got money, I've got some resources. Custom weapon too. Minus 2 hit points, plus 2 damage. That's going straight on my artillery, that. Uranium factory level 1. I've got targeting drones now, so I'm going to replace that one I lost. And... storage one? What? Okay. I've got a storage blueprint, apparently. Don't know what that is for. Don't know what that's for at all. Okay, Baron. Maggots, you hurt... No, hang on. I need a suitably evil voice for him. A suitably evil voice. Right, let's see. Will this one do? Maggots, you hide, then attack out of the blue, taking the planet piece by piece like rats. Hey, Iron Mark III, if you really are a lord, you should come to me as any real lord would. We'll have a fair fight. I'm broadcasting this from my residence. Come now. Right, yeah, that's definitely his voice. I have the coordinates for the signal source. So it's over here. The Kutner Forests. Gathering all his troops in the area, so the battle will be the hardest one so far. That's fine. If I can actually deploy all my troops, I mean, I got through that with just the loss of a single jeep. No, not a single jeep. I lost my targeting drone for that. But my forces are otherwise okay. I don't want to move that. Move base. Base thing. Move. Okay, so what can I do now? I think I need to start some do some digging again. Because I think I build another foundry. No, I can keep adding foundries as I need. Same with uranium. I can add another factory. Where's the storage? Contains modules and resources. So, okay, that can hold more stuff. Fine. But yeah, I think that about does it. I've just overrun the half hour mark. I'm just going to swap out custom weapon 2. Two hit points, but hits for 5. So this thing basically hits like a freight train. But I've got to watch out. I've got to keep it intact with my tanks, because this thing just can't take any hits by itself. It's a glass cannon kind of deal. Or if I really wanted to, I could take off the module and probably put another custom weapon on it. Yeah, this thing deals 6 damage, range of 4, but it'll blow up if anything so much as sneezes in its general direction, so yeah, I think not. The range is definitely a useful factor. Being able to outrange stuff, very good. But yeah. 6 damage from those things though. Ooh, that would be good if I could keep them alive. I generally can't, so yeah. Anyway, I'm going to have to call it there. Because, as I said, just past half hour mark, so that's all well and good. I need to dig out a room as well. Dig, dig, dig. I'm going to plan to put my other research centre over here. But I need a uranium factory as well, so that needs to be here. Yeah. I don't have the space, though, to add a... Oh, wait. I didn't get a... Wait, what did I lose? I know I didn't lose any drones. I lost a targeting drone, but now it's 70... Oh! Of course, yeah. Got that thing over there. Which is... Oh, I can take them apart. Okay. Right, scorpion tanks, level 1. 10 hit points. Moves 2 spaces. Deals 4 damage. Range of 2. It's got an aura for friendly units, which grants plus 1. So, oh. That is very nice, actually. I want to pair this thing with my artillery pieces, actually. So this thing will guard my artillery pieces and make sure that they get all the support they require. So those things are going to hit by trains regardless now, because they'll have this thing next to them, giving them a damage buff. Basically. Oh, this is going to be glorious. Absorb a certain amount of incoming damage. Critical hit chance. Hit points. I want this thing to survive a little bit better. I want to actually put... Let's salvage that from my Lord units. Give him more health. because I'm relying on my other forces more than him. And then give my regeneration 1 to the Scorpion tank. So this thing's not meant to be in direct combat much. It's the only one I've got. But it'll move with my artillery and protect them. And also buff their damage and make them hit even harder. So that sounds good. Just one more thing I want to do. Upgrade Scorpions, hit points, critical chance, extra module slot straight away. Then it can move through forests without any problems. It does get extra range eventually, and it gets a repair aura. A Scorpion tank can fix other units when it's nearly maxed out, so that's going to be quite a while. I looked, and level 2 research centers can only push to level 7, so that's going to be way down the road, that, but eventually this thing can fix my other units by one hit point per turn. Not much, but oh dear, I like that high-tech tank, I really do. But it gets the extra range later on too, so that's nasty. Anyway, enough of that, enough drooling over the giant robotic scorpions. This has been Iron Mark 3, thank you very much for watching. Wait, no. Voice. Right. This has been Robotic Lord Iron Mark 3. He thanks you for watching and hopes that you enjoyed the show. He might care to see you some other time. And we'll see you all later. I swear, I butcher that outro every time I do it.